Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Harder Dolls. As you can see, I'm back with a new video, and this time I will show you how I do Agent Twilight slash Loid Forger from Spy Family. This anime has been one of my favorites this season, and I couldn't sit idle by doing nothing. Besides, Loid is an excellent character and with a design that has caught my attention since the first time I saw him. And as in every new project, I draw the concept of the character, giving it my own style when I'm working on his face. Oh, but before I start, I wanna thank you all for your support on YouTube. My channel has finally reached 1k subscribers. All my effort that I make with each project after 3 years has finally paid off, and you have no idea how excited I feel right now. Seriously, thank you guys. I'm so happy. So, if you're new here, I invite you to subscribe to my channel and ring the bell to get notified when I upload new videos. And without further ado, let's get started! For the base doll, I will use the J-Hope doll from BTS, since both the shape of his head and his proportions seem appropriate to make Loid. So, the first thing I'll do is remove his face and hair so I can work better. With his head out of his body, I take my scissors so I can cut the hair close to the root. After that, I start scraping the inside with a flat screwdriver. The good thing about these heads is that they don't have glue inside, which makes it faster to remove each hair. And now, the usual problem when working with these dolls. My recommendation for this is to press the cloth quite a bit on the surface and make quick movements, obviously using pure acetone. That way, I avoid using so many cloths staying this way. As you can see, I already prepared Loid's hair off camera using acrylic yarn, and I must say that this color looks pretty cool for a shape of blonde. With that, I prepare my wig cam on the doll's head, making sure that it's completely fixed. Off camera, I already fixed the middle of the hair so that I can glue the other wets of the hair on the wig cap. Now with the hair attached, I begin to cut little by little from the bottom and thus avoid having problems when it comes to style it. As you can see, I fixed it with needles to be able to style it better. And now I will release the bone that I made to be able to work on the upper part in the same way as I did with the lower part. Achieving a hairstyle like Loid was a bit difficult, as I want a more detailed touch, and I know it will look 100% the same, but at least I was able to achieve something that would fit better on the doll's head. With that, I finished fixing with hairspray since I don't like my dolls to lose shape on their hairstyle. And with that, it's ready. Okay, I think it's the first time that I show how I remove a wig after having worked it, since seeing it with or without the plastic is very different. And always leaves glue residue which I have to cut. Looking like this without the plastic. Oh, but that's not all. Since I have hair left over, I made Loid another wig recreating his disheveled look. Because if I was going to make this character, I also had to make his second hairstyle, which also I really like, and just like the first one, it also looks great on him. And as always, let me know in the comments of the video which is your favorite. And with that, it's time to make the repaint. As you can see, I already put the doll head on his body and applied 3 layers of MSC to be able to work. Off camera, I draw the rest of the lines of the eyes in order to have the most symmetrical and proportionated shapes and thus be able to focus on the fills and outlines of the doll as I draw them in my concept. Now, speaking a little about Spy Family, I felt that it has been one of those animes that catch your attention when you saw the aesthetics and plot of the first time. I really like the roles that the Forger have in this story, since they had to hide their true identities for their own benefit, being Loid a spy, Yor an assassin, and Anya a telepath. The dynamic they all have being a fake family makes without a doubt a very entertaining anime to watch. Loid is a very attractive man, and also I want to achieve that with his repaint. Achieving those outlines on his face was a bit difficult, since they had to fit well on the face of the base doll, and in the end I think I achieved it by passing the first line in his face. Also, I don't know if I'm the only one who thinks so, but his face is very adorable when he's blushing and is embarrassing. Seriously, it's very funny. Now with another layer of spray, I color his eye with a layer of light blue, and then outline certain areas on his face with a cream pencil. With a dark brown tone, I touch up more his facial lines. And now with a black pencil, I highlighted the eyelashes more very carefully. I think the only thing I hate about this pencil is they are very sensitive to touch, which makes them breaking very quickly. After another layer, I decided to brush the watercolor since the pencil wasn't helping me at this point, and so I was able to achieve a better outline in certain areas on his face. With that, I finished outlining his face using acrylic paints and tubs to give a better finish with brighter colors. And to finish, I apply gloss varnish to the whites of the eyes and lids. And this is how Aging Twilight's face looks. Without a doubt, having done it in my style gives a very different aesthetic from the original design that I really like a lot. Now let's see how the doll looks with the hair on. Oh my god, he looks too handsome! Anya, I like your papa. But seriously, I like the result. This is what the dog would look like with his other hairstyle, and I can't believe that it also looks good now that I made his face. And with that done, now I'll make his clothes. Finding a fabric of the same color as Loid's suit was very difficult, but luckily I was able to find this one, which is covered in fabric. The color became quite similar to that of his suit when I saw it, and the best thing is that it was cheap and with a discount. So, now that my parts are cut, the only thing I will do is to sew everything by hand. And this is how both pieces turn it out. To make the coat, I use the clothing pattern of the BTS dolls, only adjusting a little more to the body. Up camera, I also made his white shirt and his vest, using this tiny fabric with a darker shade of green, as well as his pair of socks. With all the clothes already sewn, I only had to glue the bottom to each piece. Some are recycled from the BTS dolls, and others I sculpted with a pot-set coat so that they resemble the others. With Epoxy, I also sculpted his label pink, which is the logo of WISE, the secret organization that Twilight works with. This piece is very small, and painting it was a big challenge. So, I just had to glue it on the coat and it's done. Definitely the bottoms gives each piece an amazing finish. Making these clothes took me a week to finish, and I think it was worth the effort just looking at it. Off camera, I position his hands in different ways so that they have more dynamism when making poses. If you want to know how I did it, check this tutorial I made. If any of you have BTS dolls, this tutorial will help you to customize their hands. Going back to the video, now I'm going to paint his hands black to simulate the gloves he wears. Now I'm going to shine them so they have a better finish, leaving them completely shiny. Every time I customize one of these dolls, I always tend to reuse their shoes, and in this case I will also do the same with this doll. Only this time I modified it a bit so that they resemble Loid's shoes a bit, using craft foam for the sole of this. And just as I did with the gloves, I will paint over them and then protect them with a layer of varnish, this time using a matte one. Leaving bow in this way. If you remember this head you see here, it was the one I was originally going to use for Yuji's repaint, which unfortunately got damaged because of the reroute. So in order to not waste it, I decided to turn it into a mask. Twilight is known to be a master of disguise every time he has a new mission, which is something that represents him a lot, and I decided to do the same with the toe. And yeah, this is something completely normal in this hobby. With the scalpel, I begin to open his eyes and make this shape. Off camera, I completely modified him with a potsy. And this is how it will look with paint on. For the design, I base it completely on the disguise of his first mission at the beginning of the anime. I not only made him the mask, I also included several accessories, which will be his gun, the watch that he wears on his wrist, and the white hat that he sometimes wears to go out, which I did the same way I did Noir's. Oh, also off camera I made his tie. And with that, Loid Forger is done. This result makes me seriously very happy. Making this character was undeniable being a great experience, seeing has made me improve in some aspects when it comes to customizing. Spy Family is seriously incredible. It is without a doubt an anime that I would recommend you to watch, and more because it will return with new episodes this October, which excites me a lot.
Good day, or perhaps good evening, Twilight. Excellent work on your last assignment. Now then, here's your next mission. You must get married and have a child.
Say what? That's right, with this dialogue I announced that this video is the first of a miniseries of repaints that I will do of a Spy Family on my channel, including Anya and Yor in them. Right now I'm working on other videos that I will release soon in a few months, but while I'm doing that I'll be looking for the perfect base dolls to make the two of them. So, thanks for watching this video, like, comment, and subscribe to my channel to see more content like this. You can also follow me on Instagram and TikTok as The Harder Dolls, and if you have suggestions for base dolls for Anya and Yor, let me know in the comments. So, that's all for today guys, my name is Eric, and I'll see you next time. Bye!